Funziona. Io sto qui principalmente perché sono l'unico che parla un po' di portoghese, quindi voglio tentare di introdurre un mondo inglese. No, prima di tutto, obrigado. A gente já fez, na verdade, uma outra parceria também com o IED, algum ano atrás, com outra exposição sobre um outro design italiano, que é o Giugiaro, que a gente fez junto com o IED. Nós estamos aqui agora, e ele vai nos apresentar mais ou menos qual é a nossa história, como é que a gente gosta de trabalhar. Nós achamos interessante mostrar este modelo de negócio, porque o que você está fazendo aqui, quando se fala de design, quando se fala de arquitetura, design e arquitetura, a gente imagina sempre mais ou menos a mesma coisa. O mundo mudou e quando se fala de marketing, se fala de brand, muda muito. Muda a forma de trabalhar porque os clientes, todo mundo, todo nós se acostumado em ver coisas em forma diferente. Antigamente todo mundo estava bem organizado em ter atenção na publicidade, num filme, em uma obra, ficava na frente de uma obra por 15 minutos. E nesse momento, quando você está na frente de uma obra em 15 minutos, no mínimo você recebe 55 WhatsApp, 2 SMS, Facebook, na desgraça. Na desgraça. Isto muda completamente a forma de comunicare com as pessoas, porque a gente não está mais concentrado, não está mais focado. Para isso, o Ico vai contar para vocês algum exemplo interessante, coisa muito diferente: um museu de Chopin em Varsávia, um museu de um banco na Itália, uma exposição de uma empresa que faz sapato. São experiências muito diferentes que você vai ver. Eu vou introduzir só dois slides, depois vou deixar ele falar. Nós chamamos isto de brand and space, porque no mundo digital, no mundo virtual, todo mundo está mais abituado em messaggi che scegliono, immagini che scegliono, ma lo spazio fisico sempre tem un'importanza molto grande per noi. Noi non crediamo che la comunicazione totalmente digitale funziona. Funziona se tem un momento che você tem una meravigliosa pubblicità di succo da bagashi, ma tem un momento che você quer tomar questo succo, senão, e quando você toma, você tem un oggetto na sua mano. Noi parliamo adesso di user experience e marketing innovation. User experience è o che tutto il mondo fa, e marketing innovation è che cada cosa che sta acontecendo nel mondo in questo momento, você tem que imaginar che qualche tecnologia può essere sfruttata in forma differente. Você va a vedere, per esempio, come noi trabalhar con applicativo fatto per gioco, per crianza, trasformando questo in contenuto per un carro da Suzuki, per General Motors. Perché noi non siamo un'impresa che consiglia di sviluppare tecnologia, è un'impresa gigante sviluppando tecnologia. Ma molte imprese sviluppano tecnologia focata in una cosa. O che buono se pegare questa tecnologia e sfruttare in altra forma. Vai, Luqui, per favore. Questo è Full Brand is All Around the Brand. Queste sono alcune logomarche che noi esponiamo qui solo per contare che questa teoria che stiamo contando sta funzionando da molti anni con alcuni brand importanti. Qui, Comau, può essere che la gente non sa, ma è il maggior gruppo del mondo che fa robotica per costruire carro, è un'impresa gigante. A Suzuki, Giugiaro è la maggior impresa di design che c'è in Italia. Stiamo parlando di un'impresa di design con 1.000 persone lavorando dentro. E disegna Nikon, Trembala e disegna Pregio, con 1.000 persone lavorando. Interessante. Intesa San Paolo è il maggior banco che c'è in Italia, General Motors e General Motors. E questo è solo per dire che questa che stiamo facendo qui non è teoria, è molto pratica. E vamo mostrare un case interessante. Vai pure, Luchi. Infelizmente, a base del nostro lavoro, infelizmente o infelizmente, è sempre un brand. O brand può essere un artista, o un brand può essere. Banco Bradesco sta patrocinando ora questa esposizione di Steve Jobs. Perché? Perché Banco Bradesco fu il primo banco che fece internet banking, perché gli chiedono di stare molto aperto alla tecnologia. Steve Jobs è un'icona, è un brand. Ah, Nutella è un brand. Oyed è un brand, Havaiana, Ferrari, Dolce & Gabbana. Quindi tutti questi sono brand. Il problema è che ora, você tem che immaginare, quando você è designer, você è architetto, o você trabalha na tecnologia, você trabalha in applicativo, tem che sapere che tem che vedere cosa da un punto di vista differente. Questa è la nostra idea. Vai pure, Luca. E agora, vou deixar a palavra para Ico Migliore, que ele é um arquiteto importante na Itália, ele tem o seu estúdio, trabalha mais ou menos em todo lugar do mundo. Nós temos uma parceria, a gente se põe junto em fazer trabalho um pouco diferente. Ico.
Thank you. Oh, thank you. Thank you. I don't speak Portuguese. Sorry, I speak Italian. If you want me, I can speak Italian. Speaks bellissimo, ma non si capisce. So I speak Italian. I love Portuguese. When he was talking, I was completely astonished, but I don't understand a word. So I was expecting to have young students, which are all are young, almost all, including me. But whatever. I teach you in many universities. I teach in Milano, Politecnico, Faculty of Design, and I also had the chance to teach in the Istituto Europeo di Design in Milano in Via Cesa. It was many years ago in the 90s, and it was a very nice experience. Now I also teach in Japan, and so I have a relationship with students. It's very, very strong, and very so the academic view is very important to me. And I'm here, of course, with Full Brand. We are having this exhibition together. I think it's a good chance. We develop many projects together with Full Brand, and I explain you after what and how we work together. But of course, I'm an architect, and to be here in Istituto Superiore di Design is very important to me. You know, the name outside the door, Vico Magistretti, I actually was one of the, when I was a young student, he selected my project. And I was selected, I hope you know Achille Castiglioni, I hope you know him. I had the chance to work with him for many years. And then I developed my expertise in the field of design. Now we're talking about spaces. I better sit, if you mind if I sit so we can see this, okay? So it's we're talking about spaces. Interior design now involves many, many different fields, many areas. It goes from retail to museums. There's a noise. Probably my mobile. That it involves many different areas, going from retail design to city design, city branding, urban design. There are many fields in which we can really develop our possible field of actions. And I just wanted to mention this, since we're working on this kind of communication spaces, I just want to tell you what we're doing on some case history, two case histories I brought here on museums, and also one also is commercial. Because also nowadays, there is a sort of an overlapping between commercial and cultural fields. This is not, is good, because in commercial work, in commercial fields, they want to develop their expertise, their story, their heritage. And in the cultural field, now, of course, they have to sell better museums, sell better knowledge, share much better the culture. This is very important. We are now, the next age is the age of sharing. We need to share things. We need to design things to be shared, public spaces, community space. This is very important. And the technology would really help us a lot in this kind of a new field. So, just to, because we don't have so much time, we have to share the conference. The lecture.
Pronto? You lost everything that I said? No? Now it's okay?
I can sing. This is, no, it's fine, this? It's better? Okay. Okay, let's move a little bit. I'm a designer, so I need to move things. So let's go now. Okay, as Marco mentioned before, when we design places for culture or even places for commercial, but I'm to be focused here more on culture. I had the chance to design the Egyptian Museum in Torino, for instance, which is probably the most important museum after Cairo, and the Leonardiana, which is another very important places near Milano in Vigevano, all focus on the production of Leonardo da Vinci. It's a very interesting place. I mean, if you come to Italy, I suggest you to go to visit both the museums. But and the approach that we have as a designer is to change this between, you know, there are two visions. One is the Nail Museum, I call Nail Museum, the old-fashioned museum, like dust place in which the, you know, masterpieces are hang on the wall. You don't even know what, why and how, it's a small label, you don't understand. And the other side, we have funfair museum, all like special kind of effect, almost like, you know, Carnevale di Rio, almost like this, you know, which is nice to be at Carnevale di Rio, but not in a museum. You have to learn, you have to understand. And in between, we have this kind of new way, which is called storytelling museum, a sort of a place as a system in which you can go and you start learning through different possibilities. So we completely change from the contents to the people. We need to change and put in the center the audience, and the visitor should be the center of our places. This is important when we design a museum, when we design a store, when we design a commercial space or a cultural space. It's important that we need to focus on behavior. I was, as I said, I worked with Achille Castiglioni for 10 years, and the most important part of his job was to be focused on what people would do, not what object would do to one to each other. The object doesn't matter. Three chairs and one table doesn't mean anything. The meaning is what we do around this table, This is the important part, and we should be focused on this part. Okay, next. The place should be a place like this, where the box and the storytelling are the key factors together, the box meaning the architecture, to become a place in which I can learn and share something. Okay? And the designer now changed a little bit his view from being only an architecture, a designer of a space interior, something that is more connected to curators. So we have a relationship. What are the contents? How to display the contents? What are the space? That's why sometimes we are called too late. Normally they call designers and architects too late, when everything is already decided. We need to be called in advance. So we need to share with the curator the possibility to decide what is most important, how to show, to display things. Otherwise, even when you design a store, they cannot call you when they have already the collection. You have to be with them from the beginning. This is very important. Of course, it's a tough project. You have to fight. You have to fight all the time. Curators and designers, they need to fight all the time, because you put your effort, they put their effort. There's no one wins, but together you can perform much better. It's almost like a strong team. And the thing is, as a designer, you have like, this is a sort of a, now this is an animation, but doesn't work. Not to me, I gave you the wrong. So it's an animation, meaning we're starting from one book, which is the brief, we reorganize the contents somehow. We redesign the script, almost like a director in a movie. You receive a script, and from that you redesign, and you think in new concept, reorganize everything to be presented. Okay? Of course, now we have to be concentrated and focused on many different layers. This is much more complicated for designers now, because instead of designing things with wood, only wood, chairs and things, we have to be focused on some layer which is not physical. Something goes beyond this. And the perception is very important, all layered together. I always say to my students, when you draw a line on a paper, just designing something, this line means what? Material, transparency, acoustic. Is not a line. When you in your head you have a line, but this line, what does it mean, this line, to me? This is important to you when you develop the project. Okay? Okay, we have three things that I'm obsessed by these three things in my project. There are pathways, not physical pathways, not only physical pathways, mental pathways. When I have to tell you something, when I have to tell you a story, which is the best, when I have to enter, when I have to exit to the story. This is a concept of a retail or a museum is the same thing. When do I tell you something and how do I expect this path? And this pathways is always also light, graphic, physical, interaction with spaces, music, sound. This is very important. People, they can learn from this different level. So the first is path. The second one is time. Time is a key factor to design a space now, to design everything. You have to, when you're in front of a computer, you design time. How much time do I spend in front of my computer? How much time do I spend inside this store? How much time do I spend in front of a text? I said yesterday when I was talking, when I meet with curators, and for instance, I design a museum, they come to me and say, oh, I write this text for the entrance. That's a big, you know, 4 pages. Oh, you have to present it. I said, no. How come do I present? Oh, yeah, you just put it on the wall. What do you mean put it on the wall? 4 pages on the wall, and then every room has another 4 pages. And they say, yeah, but this is important. And then easy. I go and says, but you know how fast a man can read? Do you know how fast a man can read? Read and learn, how fast? Between 80 and 100 words a minute. 80 and 100 words a minute. And if you read something about the Egyptian, or if I read something about the history of Rio, that I have to be very focused and keen, probably I go down on 60 words if I need to understand. So if I write down 4 pages, how can I will stay in front of that, you know, for 5 or 6 minutes, 10 minutes. That means that I occupy the space, and the time is important. And also the time is very important in organizing places. Many people, they say, oh, I went to Louvre. I went to Louvre. It's like, I went to Rio. Did you see Rio? No. It's like, I went in a grocery, I ate everything. I can't. I just picked something, you know. I cannot eat everything. If I went to Louvre, I saw Louvre. No, I saw 4 or 5 good pieces, and I try, and I go back. The idea is also to use spaces in a way the people go back. Like in a store. In a store, people, they go and they go back. They go by another time. We do the same in museums. A museum should be a new way of spaces, cultural spaces, where the people, they don't go there just once. They should go there. They should have a ticket for 1 year. I buy a ticket and then I go back and forth many times as I want, because I can learn better. I cannot see. I go to Louvre and I see La Gioconda in front of 10,000 people behind the glass and with no light. Oh, gee, I was very nice. Well, it's better to see on the paper. It's my, you know. So this is how. Yeah, but I was there. So the time is very important. The next one, of course, is the one that we really experiment together with Full Brand. The change of the frame. Frame completely has changed. This is a frame. The room is a frame. This is a frame. This is a frame. This is a frame. We can change. The frame went beyond the physical part, and we could add to this frame many different characteristics and many different possibilities. And through new technology, this frame was completely beyond everything, beyond the place. And I can keep this frame. I can bring it to me at home. This is important. We have to think about spaces in this way. Go ahead. So I would just leave you with this last, and then we go to the project very fast. But this is the last suggestion. When I design spaces, I design places in which the exhibition is sort of a mirroring effect. So the people, as I said, should enter the frame. They should enter, be in the frame, not be outside. The idea of sharing is this idea. I share the space. I share the stage. I would like to have you on stage with me when I'm talking, because this is, then we learn better. We can be more into it, instead of just being detached. And I have the culture, you don't have it, so just give you some suggestion, okay? So this is the important to me. And this is, the mirroring effect is something, not physical mirror, okay? Tutto bene? Tutto bene. So the mirror effect is something that drag you in the condition of being inside, almost like playing a football game. I'm not just, you know, being excited of this. And we like to design spaces like this. I would like to people excited. I remember Castiglioni. He was so excited about his job. That's why sometimes they don't want to pay us. This is a problem, because they see us very excited. They say, well, he's happy, by the way. No. Let's go. Okay, this is very interesting, just as a last image. This is Las Meninas Velázquez. This is probably the most virtual in the 16th century, because there's Velázquez there painting Las Meninas, and the father and mother of Las Meninas were there. We have a mirror. We probably see ourselves in the mirror. And so it's something very, very, there's a mystery behind this paint. If you have the chance to see it real, you almost see yourself, but I'm there, or something is looking at me, or so something very strange. You have to try to drag people inside this kind of a thing. Okay, let's go for, it's not very clear, no, but what's this? So the museum, as I said, the museum or commercial spaces, now there should be something, a slow release and activating moment that you can start to get your energy, and later you will learn more. You maybe go to a museum and you start learning and thinking, I develop my studies in this kind of a field. Okay, go ahead. Okay, this is the Chopin Museum. I have 3 case history very, very, very fast. Probably if we turn off the light, it would be better to see the projection. Oh, it's fine. You know, okay. No, va bene. Okay. Eh? Better turn it off? Then you sleep after? No. Okay. Just turn it off. No, I just because I see some light here. Okay, this is a competition in 2006 and 2000. We won the competition. It was international competition by the government of Polish government, and there was many studios apply for this. We were lucky to win the competition, and we developed the project of the museum that was open in 2010. For yeah, it's better, no? Yeah. Okay, 2010 for the bicentenary of the Chopin when he was born in Warsaw. Chopin is a composer, I think you know Chopin composed, and he was Polish, not French. Many people they think that Chopin was from France, but this is not the truth. Chopin was born in Poland, and the Polish government invested and wanted to brand. This goes to branding. He wants to brand his nation with Chopin, because Chopin lived in Poland until he was 20, and then he died when he was 39. So half of his life he lived in Poland, and he had to leave because the Russian came to Poland, and he had to escape to Paris. So this was a very interesting museum. It was a museum and is a museum. It's still open. If you go to Warsaw, I suggest you to go in Poland. And where it's very live museum, a very alive. There's the music. There's a soundscape. It's a very active museum. The way we won the competition was like this. You can go. There's an old palace, completely restored, like almost like this palace, like this building here, and very beautiful. And we design inside is not many pathways, different pathways. Since we had many rooms, every room is almost 11 different museums. From you know when he was born, his period in Noan, his period in Warsaw, his period in Paris. By the way, every room one con- so you can browse from one room to another, learning different stories, and you can memorize and you can learn much better through different stories instead of telling you the old chronological life of Chopin. You may be more interested in how he was dealing with girls, how he was dealing with architecture. So this is important to get more inside the image. And the idea of things is important because we, bottom line, we work on identities. I work, when I was a student, I try to find myself, what is my identity? What I'm going to do? I want to be a good architect. This is not enough. There are many good architects. I want to be a great architect. Among whose? It's very complicated. So, and I met good people. I met Castiglione, I met Magistretti, I met these people, and I understood that there is a pathway that, following that pathway, that is your pathway, you can be, you can find your, and you can build your own identity. And the thing that we're doing with our, as a designer, then we can work on others' identities. If we can learn who am I? What do I think about things? Okay. So go. So this is the palace. I don't want to go too much in details, but just to let you know, and I have a clip after to show you what it is. Avanti. But the idea is also that this museum will focus the people as a center of the museum, the audience. So the museum speaks, is a museum that has, you know, interaction. We can listen to the music, you can browse inside the many contents, different contents. There are original contents and music. Vai avanti. This, for instance, is the period, the cellars, the bottom layer cellars are completely renovated, and they were this kind of a shape. And we have original contents in this kind of a showcases. But just by approaching and touching with your ticket, the museum speaks 8 languages and 5 different levels of possibility to interact with kids, with no impaired people. They cannot hear very well, they cannot see very well, and also expert and ordinary people in music like me, for instance. I can. Okay, go ahead. This is just to give you how we can drag the people in a new dimension. Those are original pieces, you know, artwork by Chopin when he was born. This is also in the cellars. And this behind this mirror, just by approaching and touching the score, sorry. But I'm excited. No, I speak slow. Come si dice bara? 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 Beleza. Beleza. I'm not beleza, I should be more beleza. Sorry. Beleza, sorry, I'm too excited. By the way, this room, and just this is In this side you have original contents. Behind this room, this behind this glass, which is polarized by touching the score, the music starts, and there are projection of people dealing and behaving almost like being in the place of Chopin. And we have original places of his father. Bye. This is another part where people they can go enter these glasses showcase in which they can listen to the music. And this wallpaper, this thing is a wallpaper that comes from Chopin. Chopin was very was a dandy, you know, was very elegant, very dandy. He liked very much the paintings, he liked very much the wallpaper. And he selected the wallpaper at home. So we selected the wallpaper that he selected, and we transform it in this kind of a glass containing which the people they can listen to the music. Okay? Go ahead. This is an interesting room. It's a Noir. Chopin suggestion. Chopin lived in Noir with George Sand. George Sand was a very elegant, strong woman. And he was a bit under George Sand. She was the man at home. But he said Chopin, when he was in Poland, in Noir, in France, he said, it was the best period of my life when I composed many things. And why? Because I was in this kind of a nature, beautiful nature, birds, wind. So we went to in Noir, we recorded with a British studio, we recorded the soundscape of Noir, and we put it in this kind of a frame, that frame on the left side. When we had images, original thing, writing of Chopin. On the right side, we selected all the sound composition that he did while he was there. And just by opening this drawer, this speaker, they would provide you with 15 seconds of music. And you can open and close these drawers, and inside the room you have natural music, natural soundscape, and a mix of continuously different, you know, pieces composed by Chopin. But at the same time, you have almost like being in his brain. I imagine his, because it's so, and you go there, and we did this with an acoustic engineer, and we understood that there's no pollution. The quality of many musics together, there's no pollution. So it was very interesting how we developed this kind of project. And you see kids, they go there, they play with this kind of, they open, close the doors. So they just, the drawers, it's very interesting, the interaction, very easy interaction, very intuitive way of people. Okay, go ahead. So this is the way it works, you know, I told you now. Okay, you open the drawer, everything starts. There's also a projection on the surface in which the score comes magically outside and we project it on top of the table. This is it, you see? Comes out and goes on top of the table. By closing the door, because it's closing the drawer, which is the last 15 seconds, 20 seconds, the music is also to preserve the original score for the lighting, because we have to have only 50 looks on the original score. So this is to preserve the score, which is a glass, and also to present you the music at the same time. Bye? Okay. Okay, this is another room, a sort of a library of Chopin, but just to go a bit. This is also an interesting part in which we have an original piano of Chopin, also in the bottom. The people, they can select music, different scores. They can put this music on top of the piano, not a piano, because we have a screen in front of it, a glass screen. And suddenly, on the top part, out right there, there is a musician playing. Since we do not have any more Chopin with us, he was a great pianist, very great pianist, Chopin. But unfortunately, there's no movie or film on him because he died. But we did with Barenboim, Blekacz, Dang Tai-son, the best pianist, we filmed them, and we have their hands playing the scores of Chopin. So the other people, they can see this. This drags people in the new experience. Someone does something, and everyone can perceive what I did. Almost like the old jukebox, you know, the jukebox when I play the music, and everybody's singing. This is the piano. Okay. And then there is also a mediateca, a place where you can download the music and listen to the music. And it's also interesting because when the people have their pathways, when they listen to the music, everything is recorded by the Institute Frédéric Chopin. not the, and they almost have a sort of a view of what the people like in terms of production of Chopin. They try to, you know, guide you to new possible pathways. So it's interesting. Avanti. This is the logo, whatever. This is two minutes. This museum won the Red Dot Design Award in Germany and was also awarded by the selection of Compasso d'Oro, which is an important prize in Italy. It's beautiful to work with this in this kind of a cultural field and try to transform and to make it easy for people to learn. And this is no matter your young or old generation. We think we should share this guy as much as possible with other people. So that's how the interaction goes. Everyone gets his own ticket. It's just like the key of your hotel and is memorized on your expertise, on your level, and just by approaching to the to different, it would talk to you in this kind of a level. You can, of course, go more in depth if you like to go deeper inside the contents. Those, the showcases are very, of course, well designed because inside we have to protect and to preserve papers and things that, are, of course, need to be protected. This is a place for kids. Only kids, they can go there without shoes. They can play with, and they can puzzle things, playing with the cartoons of Chopin. So it's interesting because the family, they can leave the kids there or they can go listen to music there. This is the room that I mentioned before. You see that instead of filming original people, we film shadows of people doing things. And also you see the cups moving and the music being, so you are dragging this kind of a dimension. And this is what happened when the music goes. Altogether, it's a mixed up music, but very interesting. Yeah, you see what happened? You open the drawer and the score comes out. So people, they can find different pathways. This is the part where Chopin was a teacher. This is a part of when he was in Paris, and he had many students. And this is the women where he had many women, a sister, mother, many students, and he was loved by his sisters. This is the one I meant before. You can choose, select the score. You can read this, you follow the score, and on top you have hands, beautiful hands of great pianists playing for you and for the audience that would follow the path. This is how we approach the project. And I think with a full brand that we are going to work together on this project of Steve Jobs in Rio, that will be like this. We want to really develop this kind of going beyond the level of did it together in many cases. We did it with the Saving Museum, which is after this one, and also the Pavilion in Expo, which is Expo Pavilion of food that we did during the Expo 2015. This is another case history, commercial case history, just to explain that we can move from one culture to another to commercial. We have a very important brand in Italy called Moreschi. They produce shoes, very expensive shoes and very good shoes. And they have 70 years last year. They called our studio to design an exhibition about them. And there was a La Triennale di Milano. You know, probably La Triennale di Milano is a building. It's called Triennale di Milano, one of the important museums. And inside, we developed this kind of expertise. Experience on this brand. Instead of showing different shoes, we want to display another view, the brand view of the company. And the brand was, go ahead, walking, the walking pleasure, not Moreschi, but much more on the walking pleasure. Avanti. The heritage, the production, and the shoe senses. That was the idea of that we developed the concept of this kind of an exhibition. The exhibition was La Triennale. It was not very big. It was about 200 square meters. It was all the Museum Chopin is very big. This is was about, but the experience is important to develop in this case. So we went. We want to have a sort of a place in which people they can really experiment a new way of thinking about. This is a storytelling machine, emotional exhibition, lighting installation, a time experience. All think about timing, how we, time-wise, how we approach and we learn something. Go ahead. This is just a sketch. So the idea is to have this sort of a magic box, and you enter the main room. This main room, you have the general idea of walking. Through video, we select like Chopin, Michael Jackson, you know, and also other thing about shoes, like you know when Bush, George Bush, got the, or when Brezhnev was with the shoe. So there are many things many things connecting to the shoe world and to walking. So and also the Camino de Compostela is something very important. And also we presented the company by just presenting all the steps. To build the shoe, to construct the shoe. And this, in the 20 minutes experience, multi-approach time, I had two big mirrors on the side. This magic box, which is in the middle, you will see it after, will be, you know, like never endless, like infinite, projected on these two mirrors on the side. Avanti. This is the projection. And we have the projection on very big wall where we have the shoe molding, the part of the shoe, 700 of this, and on top of this a fabric and projecting on three-dimensional thing is almost like having an hologram, very, very interesting thing. Go ahead. Avanti. And inside the box, the people, they browse outside, then they enter this box. Inside the box is like this. Could you live under the to be a day under the surface of the city? We film, of course, in studio. And in this box, you will see something like surreal, unreal, because you see people walking and wind. This is the conception, light, video, audio, interaction. There is also a physical place, because the people entering this room read leather, very beautiful quality of leather. They can touch the leather. And the sound is also immersive in this room. Avanti. So this is the way. Outside, the two mirrors, and inside the room, which is 4 meters by 4 meters, only 15 people can enter at the same time in this room. And this is 2 minutes of experience of one day under the level of the ground. Avanti. This is some images. This is the you know, small clip about walking, about different contents in walking. This is a big projection, huge projection, with many sentences, works and words about walking. This is the video that we design. Avanti. And this is the room. The room is made of rubber, almost like a shoe rubber. You know, very, very anechoic and doesn't reflect any light, doesn't reflect any sound, just by entering it. And this is a door made of leather. You can touch the leather and you can enter. Avanti. And inside this room, you have on your top of your ceiling, there is a projection from above, projecting this kind of experience of one day, wind, sun, from the beginning, 2 minutes. And outside, and underneath, you have mirrors, and you have these big pipes, transparent pipes, with original material, original leather, you can touch, and you can see with this kind of LED projection. Avanti. Facciamo vedere. Okay, this is a graphic edit. We can go beyond. You can show. This is the 1 minute clip. Musica. Thank you. control of the light and the projection seems almost like going like give you the idea of an hologram, which is not an hologram. Inside, very simple, but almost like an hologram. Inside the room, you will find this. In 2 minutes, we summarize what's going to happen in 1 day from sun, from the morning until we go back to sleep, and you know, rain, wind, and also by hearing movement and people walking. So the experience was surprising, and there was a kid. Then a kid asked to his mother. I was also there. Yeah, but there is people walking. I said, no, it's not people. It's just. And of course, since we had mirror on the top part, was like an infinite layer of interaction with this kind of a world. And you can breathe and touch the leather. So it was very interesting and very like emotional for people to enter this small room. Okay. Fino a che ora abbiamo? Posso andare avanti? Can I go? Posso andare ancora avanti un altro? Poi tu. Okay. This is the museum, the Saving Museum, where we did together this project. And it is in between. I mean, in the Museum of Chopin, we have many original contents, many scores, an history of the music, soundscape, whatever. In the commercial things for a brand was the heritage of this brand to be presented, but thinking that the most important part was walking pleasure. You have your shoes because you need to walk, not because you want to see your shoes, but you need to walk. And this one with contents, of course, this one is about saving. What, as Marco Guidone said before, is a bank that called a competition for this. We won the competition and we did it together. And is about this in this kind of a place where there's no original contents. Everything is built at the same time. With Full Brand, we develop the contents, we develop the video, we develop the way of the real contents selected for people, for young generation, for elder generation, for kids. And it was very interesting to develop. This is almost like a place in which you can play with the money. Not real money, but it's not like a casino, like this place where it used to be a casino. No, not like that. But you can understand how is. Go ahead. There are many rooms, but I will show you the video, which explains you very well, so you can see part in which you can listen, and part where you can have information about. This is interesting. This part is interesting, almost like Chopin. There is a mirror, magic mirror, and just by approaching in front of those two places in which they suspend your books, just by touching a selected book, suddenly from behind this wall would appear Molière. Shakespeare and tell you the story about money in the poetry, in the pièce. So I mean, it was very interesting with a personal speaker. You can listen to him, who's an actor in this case, and it was interesting because there are many contents in relation to money, and in the history, like Avaro di Molière, piuttosto che. Okay, now I can show this. This is in probably in Brasiliano, in Portuguese.
Buongiorno, benvenuti al Museo del Risparmio. Io mi chiamo For, sono il padrone di casa. Per qualunque domanda sul mondo dell'economia e della finanza, io sono qua. Chiedetemi pure qualunque cosa. Io so tutto. Parola di For.
O visitante na entrada do museu é recebido por vídeo de boas-vindas que não precisa de óculos 3D. O Museu del Risparmio, que em português seria Museu da Poupança, é único para o tema proposto e para atividades que envolvem os visitantes, que podem participar e ativar o conteúdo movendo-se entre as estações dispostas em 5 salas diferentes ou parar para olhar algumas relíquias. 2 personagens especiais, For e Miga, que sabem muito de poupança, vão orientando os visitantes ao longo do caminho. Na entrada, você não receberá um bilhete simples, mas um cartão. um crachá personalizado que permite que você ative o conteúdo e ser reconhecido nas estações para acumular pontos durante a visita. 5 perguntas testes podem medir o conhecimento dos fundamentos da poupança no início e no final da visita. O Museu del Risparmio é dividido em 5 áreas que são chamados de conhecer, entender, narrar, sonhar e experimentar. Conhecer é um espaço onde o visitante pode aprender sobre as origens do dinheiro, da época do escambo até o aparecimento da moeda. Do nascimento de empresas à evolução do sistema monetário internacional até o euro e a atualidade. Neste ambiente, há espaço e conteúdos dedicados às crianças que podem brincar com aplicativos simples projetado para aproximá-los dos conceitos fundamentais de poupar e gerir o seu dinheiro. Continuamos a nossa visita na sala Entender, um ambiente temático onde vídeos engraçados ajudam a mover-se e navegar pelo universo das ações, títulos, derivativos, seguros e muito mais, explicando características e diferenças para saber mais sobre como eles funcionam e o que eles são. Na sala Narrar, encontramos os grandes personagens da literatura oferecendo inéditos e surpreendentes pontos de vista sobre as questões de economia e finanças. Sonhar é a sala dedicada ao cinema, onde você senta e cadeiras confortáveis para ver como o dinheiro, a poupança e as finanças foram interpretados pelos diretores e atores famosos. E se, no final, você ainda tem alguma dúvida, pode voltar nos espaços e perguntar ao super especialista do museu, Fork, com o seu famoso blog de vídeo, responde as perguntas.
Dunque, iniziamo dalla prima domanda. Mi scrive Down John 77. Caro Fork, no, questa no, questa la scartiamo perché non so rispondere. Passiamo alla seconda.
Professores, arquitetos, comunicadores, especialistas em finanças, diretores e muitos outros profissionais com comprometimento e paixão transformam a ideia em realidade.
This was very interesting because it was almost like a game playing, and we developed the concept and the contents with Full Brand, which is very interesting to be developed together. Was a very interesting experience, a new experience for Torino. I just want to finish with a video that would last 1 minute. Branding goes beyond and goes to city. We need to brand our cities. It's important to give identity to. We have a very nice city, very of course, very strong image. But we should now we're working on many different opportunity. One was very interesting. This one awarded with the Golden Compasso d'Oro in Italy. And this is just during in 2011, there was a 150 years of reunification of Italy, and the city of Turin wanted to have an installation, a big installation in the center of the city. We provide them with Philips, you know, the Philips, the company, this system of lighting in the top, in most important building and museum and iconic building, almost like Tour Eiffel in Paris. We have La Mole Antonelliana in Torino, and this light was completely detached and away from the top of the at 100 meters, and from all the city you could see this lamp. But the conception of the light was working in the fog, because this light was not projecting, was indirect light, and the light was almost like projecting the color on the limbo from inside. And since in Torino, like a northern city, there's fog, there is a small rain and something, it was very nice the way it was floating inside in the air. And it did it for 1 year, and it was a very interesting project and very complicated to be done. And I'll show you how it's done in 1 minute, and then then it's over. Falla partire. This is how they built this on top of, this is a very historical museum designed by Antonelli, great architect, and was a complicated project developed with Philips and sponsored by Philips. And the president of the Italian Republic turned it on the day of the 2011, 150 years of reunification. This is included in one program that is called Luci d'Artista, Artist Lighting, that has Torino. Instead of having stupid lighting that we have in Milano, for instance, just to say that there is Christmas, you know, they call many good artists, Daniel Buren, Rebecca Horn, many good artists, to design light for the city. And they bring this sort of a museum open to light and to the city during the Christmas time. I think it's very interesting to share culture in this opportunity, instead of, you know, just putting light, whatever, you know, with stars or something, put something that artists, they can share with you possible new ideas and new contents. This was very interesting view that the cities of Torino had, and I think some city they can go on. And this goes also on the identity of the city of arts, instead of the city only of. It was pretty interesting, and you can see it now. It's the last they put it on the, and then they assemble on the last floor, and then through cables, and also with the wind, it was moving a little bit without affecting the old building, which is protected, of course, by the. Very much protected. It was pretty complicated, but interesting. Very much interesting. It's a beautiful building in the very center of the city. Okay, now thank you. I think it's over. Vai avanti. Next slide. Next. Okay, now with.
No. As Marco said at the beginning, the word brand is clear. We don't need more information or more specification about brand. But if we speak about space, we need some more attention. Why? Because if you think about the user is surrounded by a space. But it's not only a physical one, it's also a mental one. And using a communication layer, the user inside the space has the opportunity to meet people, places, objects, relations, beliefs, thoughts. So is the communication layers then, at the end of the journey, make possible to have a life. Because the space where the user meets the brands, and this happens through communication all the time. Doesn't matter if it is a real world or a fantastic one, if you are at home or in a public square, but it's a place and a place that could be different, but the space where you have your life physically and mentally. Actually, what happens that with the communication layer, you create reality. And you create many kind of reality all the time. It could be real, surreal, imaginary, divine, mental, human. But are these kind of realities that everyone has, meets all the time. What is interesting is that the digital layer changed everything. In the middle of the 90s, the digital layer changed in a way that didn't happen before. The relationship that the user has with the realities. And my second career started in the middle of 90s. I founded one of the first Italian web agency, and in 97 I wrote the program for the digital course in IEDO Torino, because Torino is my city. Okay, what is next? See that the digital domain changed the relationship, and the space between the user, the relation between the user and the space, as I said, in a way that we didn't have before, and has had many names: mail, search, blog, e-commerce, social network. Just when you arrive at the end, nowadays you speak about augmented reality, virtual reality, immersive reality. And what is different for us that now we have the phone, the smartphone. You can call Android, iPhone, but the fact that the smartphone is very different from the other devices. Why? Because in Italy, in USA, there is a law that says that if you have a damage to your smartphone, like a damage to your person, because the smartphone is a part of us. All of you have a phone, probably now in your hands, because we use it all the time. But we have a different approach, and I will speak about how we don't work for the augmented reality, we don't work for the immersive or digital reality, but we work for the user augmented experience. We use the tools from the user point of view because we want to create an augmented experience for the user. We are not interested to create a solution of augmented reality or immersive reality or things like that. We want to give the user an unique experience, an augmented experience. How? Now I will show you two examples. Project we did in 3-4 years. The first one is working right now. We started in 2013. It's a work with General Motors, okay? And we are working with them nowadays. General Motors has